Welcome to the Cuesta Library. As a Cuesta student, you have access to a variety of databases that you can use to find scholarly sources. What is a database? Simply put, a database is just an organized collection of information. Let me show you what I mean. Cuesta Library databases can be found here on the library's homepage. Our full list includes over 60 databases. Each one will look a little different, but they'll all function similarly. To choose a database, you can browse the full list, or you can search for a specific subject, database type, or vendor. If you're still not sure which database to use, Cuesta librarians have selected some of the most popular and displayed them here on the right. I will show you how to use two different databases. First, I'll choose Credo Reference and take a look at how it works. There are several different ways to look for scholarly sources. I can type a keyword or phrase in the search box, or I can browse popular topics. This is a great place to start if I haven't already chosen a research topic and I need some ideas. Let's take a look. Minimum wage sounds like an interesting topic, so I'll choose that. This is a topic landing page. Looking around the page, you'll see you have general background information on the topic here, a list of sources like articles and images right here, and on the right, we've been given a tool called a mind map that will help me explore subtopics. First, I'll review the background information and choose Read More to get more information. This is a great alternative to Wikipedia. Heading back to the topic landing page, I can then browse the list of articles I was given. The first article is perfect for my research project, so I'll click on it to get the full text. Note that there are options to print, save, and cite the article. If I head back to my results, you'll see that there are options to narrow down my list of results. For example, I can choose only pro-con articles that were published within the last few years. Now I'll choose an article from my narrowed results list to view. This one looks interesting, so I'll click on the article to view the full text. Again, I've been given the options to cite, print, email, and download the article. I will head back to my full results list, and if I'm still not seeing something interesting, I can use the mind map tool on the right to explore other related topics and subtopics. Let's take a look at the Fair Labor Standards Act. I've now been taken to a new topic landing page and can find a new set of information and sources on this more specific topic. And that covers the basics of navigating the database Credo. Let's look at one more database before we finish up. I'll head back to our full list of databases. Opposing viewpoints is another smart option, especially when researching controversial topics and writing pro-con articles. Remember, each database will look different, but many will have similar tools. For example, Opposing Viewpoints has a Browse Issues tool that allows you to search through popular issues as potential research topics, just like Credo did. Instead, I'm just going to use the search box this time. Once again, I've been taken to a topic landing page. You can choose Read More to get trustworthy background information on the topic. Heading back to the topic landing page, you'll see all of your results are organized by type. This can save you a lot of time if you're looking for something specific. You'll see we have academic journal articles, primary sources, audio files, videos, and more to select from. Scrolling down, you'll again see all of the sources organized. Click on any one to view the full content. Note that there are tools to cite, email, download, and print the article, just as we saw in Credo. When I'm done with this article, I can click results to head back to my full list of sources on my topic. And that was it. Using databases is easier than you think. I hope you're now ready to search on your own for scholarly sources through the library. Getting familiar with these tools takes time, so librarians are available to help you. We hope to hear from you soon.